Hello. Hi, wise ones. This is Stephanie Lindloff from Our Natural Wisdom. I am feeling called to talk about planning. I am a recovering Uber planner. I used to plan out so much of every moment, and I think that when kids came into the scene almost 10 years ago, things radically changed. And my approach to planning changed too. Hi, I don't know who's there, but it's nice to see that a couple people are there. Good morning. And my daughter is waving to me through the window. She's sending me a message. This is the life, you guys. I am doing some more in-depth planning for the coming year than I have in the last several years. And I just wanted to reach out and let you know that when we are high achievers and when we have these parts of us, our manager parts, who really want things to go according to some sort of a regiment or a schedule, and we really keep ourselves to it. Hi, hello Jill, nice to see you. About 4 years ago, realized that I had swung radically in the other direction, which was I literally wanted to be irresponsible. I was feeling called to be irresponsible, to not follow all of the rules, to not have a strict plan. And I kind of lived in that space for a while, I'd say a couple of years, really. And it served me very well. But, you know, now I'm really reawakening to the value, the beauty, and all of the fulfillment that we can find through self-discipline. And when I say discipline, my wonderful coach, Lisa Espinosa, says that when we're disciplined, we are being disciples to our souls. And isn't that beautiful? So I have really embraced the whole concept, the whole approach to being more disciplined in my time. And especially in this coming year, I'm really focusing more on my schedule and how it will best serve me to be more disciplined. Last year, I realized that a lot of my discipline was really focused on my mind and my mindset and my observing myself and being aware of how my thoughts were affecting me in ways that did not serve me. So discipline can look a lot of different ways. And it just feels like an important thing to talk about at this time of year because, you know, so many of you, I'm sure, are really focusing on schedules and establishing new habits and routines and practices and goals. And this is all beautiful. And I just really encourage you to be observant of what your needs are right now, because sometimes when we're going through a time where we're trying to schedule ourselves and be disciplined, there's deeper needs deeper needs that come up for us, whether it's having more self-care time, spending more time outside, connecting with nature, just from your backyard, or just in the, you know, winter, opening a window and making sure that you're breathing fresh air every single day. Just standing out on your front stoop and breathing in the beautiful air of winter. We are having a little light snowfall right now, and it reminds me of the winter solstice celebration that I led and that you can watch here on Facebook Live, on my Facebook page. I realized, I really experienced and shared with everybody attending how snow is like a light language that the universe is showering down upon us. And there's so much wisdom and blessings and beauty and joy to be found in that. And I've experienced this with rain as well and with sunlight. There's so much to gain from being outside. It'll bring you so much. It'll really rest your your systems, all of your systems, your nervous system, everything. Being in nature will be so restful for you, and it will bring you more clarity in terms of how best to plan your coming year. So if you are feeling called to plan something for the coming year or the coming month or the coming week, I really encourage you to take the time to connect with the healing and the clarity of being in nature and how this will serve your approach to your planning. And know that our approaches to planning change. We go through cycles just like nature does. And so we may have very different approaches to planning this year than we did last year or the year before. I know mine has changed dramatically. And I know that as long as I am really listening to what my soul needs and is guiding me to integrate in my life and in my approach to planning, that I am on the right path. And I'm taking one step at a time, and I'm on the right path as I do it. So just wanted to reach out to you today. I'm engaged in a little bit more goal setting and planning and charting things out this morning and sharing some systems that I use with clients, and I thought it would be a good topic for me to share with you. So I'm wishing you all the best, and I hope that you have a beautiful day. If you would like to learn more about the work that I offer, the support that I offer, please do check out ournaturalwisdom.com, and I will talk to you soon. Okay, bye.